Hey, what's up jabronis? Mano back here with yet another Destiny 2 video guide. You may have noticed that leveling in Season 14 or Season of the Splicer is different than it has been in past seasons, especially to you Destiny no-lifers out there. There's a bunch of changes to leveling that have happened, and this video is going to be your one-stop shop in figuring out how to level to 1320 power quickly or as efficiently as possible. The key to doing this is to make sure that you understand the systems that are in place, plus how to game the system so that you can get to those higher power levels very quickly. The main reason I'm making this video is that some players may have lapsed in the previous seasons or expansions, and now in Season of the Splicer, the Vault of Glass raid from Destiny 1 is coming back, and there are a ton of people wanting to come back into Destiny 2 and enjoy the new version of this founding raid in Destiny history. In addition, this video is for people who want to engage in more endgame activities like Trials, the Master and Grand Master Nightfalls, the Master and Heroic Lost Sectors, Iron Banner, and more endgame content that comes out as the season progresses. There's always new weapons to earn, new awesome gear to chase, so this is going to give you a leg up on the competition. For those folks who've been playing consistently, you may already know a lot of these tips, but some of these things might be new updates to the season that you may not know that may have changed. So this guide is going to cover everything from starting a new character at a lower light level all the way to the pinnacle cap at 1320. So with that, let's go ahead and get started. First things first, how is our power level actually determined? That's super easy. It is an average power level of all your weapons and gear, no ghost included, plus, if you have it, any power bonuses that you get from the seasonal artifact. We're going to split this into two parts of the video. We're first going to cover the gear level and save the artifact level power bonus until the end of the video. So what does gear level mean? Gear level means the three weapons that are currently equipped on your character plus the five armor pieces that are equipped. So that is your kinetic weapon, energy weapon, power weapon, your helmet, gauntlets, chest piece, legs, and class item. All of those gear power levels are then added and then made an average. That average is going to give you your power level. The first goal we have to complete is to collect gear that's going to help boost the average power of our player. Since the Season of the Chosen, all the weapons and armor were brought up to 1100 power levels, so it's from there that we're going to start our climb. It's important to know that you should follow these steps in this order, as you don't want to waste rewards that could help you farther down the line when raising your power. There are three power level caps that you need to be aware of, as your power level is related to those caps, and that influences the things that you should be doing to raise your power. They are the soft cap, the hard cap, and the pinnacle cap. We're going to start off with the soft cap, which for Season 14 is 1260 power. All blues and legendaries will help you to power up. Basically, anything from the game will help you to improve your power level. It won't matter. The key thing to remember while you are at this point is that you should run basic activities like strikes, story missions, and other things like that. You should not be in any playlist activities if you can help it, because that will take more powerful and pinnacle rewards from you down the road. Getting to the soft cap is relatively easy, but once you reach the soft cap, the next destination is the hard cap, which for Season of the Splicer is 1310 power. At this point, you're going to need to start looking for items called powerful rewards in the game. Again, you don't want to pick up any pinnacle weapons or gear. You want to focus on getting powerful rewards. In addition, I'm going to show you a technique on how to backfill your character while in this phase of the leveling, which I'll explain in just a minute. But here are the activities that you can complete to earn powerful rewards. They are getting powerful engrams at tier 1, powerful engrams at tier 2, PvP, glory, and valor rank ups, gambit rank ups, completing bounties via the Drifter, Shax, and Zavala for gambit, PvP, and strikes, the Exo Stranger Challenge, the Europa Challenge, Trials of Osiris wins at 3 and 5 wins, the Netcrasher Triumph, which is where you complete the season override activity, the old Cryptolith lure system, which is from Season of the Hunt, Umbral Engrams, some of them will actually come out as powerful, and then decrypting them, the Battlegrounds playlist for those who own Season of the Chosen. In addition, you can also get those powerful rewards from exotic or pursuit weapons or the Twitch Prime collection activity. So what you want to do is use these activities as much as you possibly can to start raising your power level on your gear. Take advantage of all of these that you can pick up. Again, do not pick up any of the Pinnacle rewards if you can help it. If you are wondering which rewards we're going to have for Pinnacles, I'm going to talk about those later on in the video. A significant change to Season of the Splicer is the removal of Pinnacle drops from the Deep Stone Crypt raid. Because of this, the Deep Stone Crypt raid should really only be run if you're looking for powerful lever rewards, weapons or gear from Deep Stone Crypt, or to get more spoils of conquest. Now we're going to talk about that concept that I talked about earlier, which was backfilling, which is critical in reaching the hard cap. Backfilling is the process of targeting loot that is dragging your character down and replacing it with more rewards that are on the level. By doing this, this will raise your gear level average up. Let's give you an example if you're lost. Let's say I'm at the soft cap. All my gear is at 1260 power, and now I'm just playing the game. I won't actually get any more powerful rewards. So now I'm going to go and earn a powerful reward. Let's say, for example, maybe I'm going to get a prime engram. I get a helmet at 1263. When I put that on my character, it's not going to raise the entire character up to 1263 because it's an average of all 8 pieces. The goal is to raise your power level on your character and then find items or backfill the other items with blues and other rewards that drop on the level. So what you do is find a place where you can farm blue items or the rare items quickly, like Team Scorched, Momentum Control, Basic Strikes, Public Events, wherever you can go to earn blues or legendaries that will be on the level. The question is, how do I make the most of all these items with limited time? Well, if you are looking to see which items you need to pick up, you need to look at an amazing tool that most people already know about but don't always use, and that's Destiny Inventory Manager. It has become the best tool for management in Destiny over the past 4 years, and it deserves that title. There's so many things it can do, but for this video, we are basically going to focus on the fact that its most important tool is the ability to show you in your character what your power level is and what gear is holding you back from raising your power level. Remember when I said your power level was an average of your gear numbers? Well, because in DIM, you can actually look and see exactly where you are. Instead of being at 1260 light, you can see that you're at 1260 and 5/8 of light. You can see which gear is pushing you forward and which one is pulling you back. For example, if all my gear is 1260, but I put an 1100 power level item somewhere, that power level is going to drop down quite a bit to 1240. Now that you know what gear is holding you back, you can start to chase the things that you need. When you're starting to power up in this process, don't throw away any blues. Blue items can help you backfill as well while you're in this process. You don't want to just infuse every weapon or piece of gear either, because your materials are limited. So wait until you get a huge bump in power and start to infuse your favorite weapons and or armor. Better yet, wait until you get a piece of gear that can be infused for glimmer only. That is going to be a duplicate weapon that you already have. Let's say I get a Truth Teller grenade launcher that's at 1310. I can then infuse that into a gear roll that I actually like on another Truth Teller. I can just put that in. Instead of it being 1309, I can make it 1310, and it only costs me glimmer. Now, we've talked about targeting different pieces of loot to raise our power. There are a number of different systems in the game that we can use right now to increase our power level. Two of them that exist directly in the game are the Cryptolith Lure, which is from the Season of the Hunt, and the Hammer of Proving from the Season of the Chosen. By upgrading or using these items, you can target different pieces of gear that will help you to raise your power level. Say, for example, I need an engineer weapon. I can go to the Cryptolith Lure and then target a Deafening Whisper energy grenade launcher. I can then target it as a powerful piece of loot that will help raise my average, or later on, I can use that and backfill using that item, and that will help me to raise my average power level. If you don't have the season passes from those seasons, you're not out of luck. You can go on through the PvP, Gambit, or Strike playlists to backfill. Going into competitive modes like PvP or Gambit and then playing games and increasing your reputation will help you to get rank ups, which will also give you powerful gear. Also, make sure that you pick up bounties from Shax of the Drifter, because when you complete 8 of those, you'll also get a powerful engram. What I recommend is choosing an activity that you like, either PvP or Gambit or Strikes, and then just repping that playlist over and over and over while finding powerful rewards. You will end up picking up one pinnacle from those activities, but as long as you don't go into all those different activities while you're repping your character and trying to raise your power, you'll be okay. If you really like PvP, or you start to run out of powerful gear rewards, go into the Freelance Survival playlist. And every time you rank up, there will be a powerful reward, and there's a lot of them. If you don't really like high-end PvP, stick to Gambit, Strikes, or Team Scorched. The games go quickly, there's really no penalty for losing, and all you have to do is spam cannons in Team Scorched, and it's super easy. Another cool trick that I mentioned in my Season 14 prep guide was the use of the previous season gear to raise power level. If you go to the previous season link that I've posted in the description of this video, you can actually collect gear from the previous season pass if you haven't actually collected them. You can actually use them then to target either weapons or armor and figure out how to actually raise your power level. These items will drop at your power level or slightly higher. It's amazing if you have completed any of those season pass tiers. As you start to level up, you'll find that you will reach a plateau at times. When you reach those plateaus, what you want to do is go find a powerful reward, backfill, and then plateau again, rinse and repeat, and do this until you've reached all your powerful rewards. Now, the thing about this is, not everyone has an infinite amount of time to play, so you'll need to gauge what speed you like to go for the power grind. If you only have a few hours to play before the weekly reset, which is Tuesdays, grind your pinnacles and your powerful rewards and get them all done every week. If you leave powerfuls and pinnacles on the table, so to speak, you'll be wasting resources that can help you level up. If you do have time, then you can prioritize in getting every single powerful weapon and gear piece that you can, then backfilling, picking up the next powerful, and so on and so on and so on until you reach the hard cap. In addition, you'll also receive prime engrams in the world that can be decrypted at Rahul, the Cryptarch, which will also raise your power level before the hard cap. Generally, there are two different types of powerful rewards that you can get. There are plus three rewards, which are the powerful tier one rewards, and then plus four, which are the powerful tier two and three. What you should do is start with the powerful tier one rewards and then pursue the powerful two and three and go forward like that. Here's the reason why. You don't want to receive a powerful tier 2 helmet at 1263 and then do a powerful tier 1 and get a helmet at 1261. It'll be a waste of reward at that point, so you want to make sure you get your powerful tier 1s and then your powerful tier 2s. If you're wondering where you can go find out what you need to complete and what activities you can do, go check out d2checklist.com. Not only will it show you which activities you can still do to get powerful gear, it will also show you the power levels for each of these activities. With that, you probably have gotten pretty close to the hard cap. And the next and final goal for the gear is the pinnacle cap. For Season of the Splicer, that's 1320 power. At this point, the only things you can do to raise your gear level are the pinnacle rewards. There are two versions of the pinnacle rewards, weak and strong. The weak rewards will give you a plus one above the hard cap. If you're still stuck beneath the hard cap, you'll actually get a plus five or a six in power level for those. With the strong pinnacle rewards, you'll get a plus two above the hard cap and a plus six or seven below the soft cap. There's really no backfilling you can do here. You just have to make sure you complete all the pinnacles every week to make sure that you have the best chance at raising your power. Some people don't know the difference between what activities give you strong pinnacles and weak activities, and that's okay, because I'm gonna tell you right now. The weak pinnacles are the Weekly Strike, Gambit, and Crucible playlist challenges. Generally, those are do three of those playlist activities. In addition, the clan rewards from Hawthorne also give you a weak pinnacle reward. After that, every single other reward labeled as a pinnacle is a strong pinnacle reward. That is the Weekly Exo Challenge, the Trials at the 7 Win Marker, the Splicer Servitor Rewiring the Light Challenge, the Prophecy Dungeon Box Completion, a 100k Point Nightfall Ordeal Completion, a Master Empire Hunt, the Digital Trove Completion, and that's the open three chests in the Override activity, the Harbinger or Hawkmoon activity, and the Presage Dead Man's Tale activity. Now currently, Presage is currently bugged, but eventually it should be dropping at Pinnacle, and that's been reported in the This Week at Bungie that you can find on bungie.net. In addition, the Vault of Glass raid will drop all Pinnacles when it launches on May 22nd, so that will be the new raid source of Pinnacles, since again, Deepstone Crypt will not drop Pinnacles anymore. So that's everything you can do to raise your gear power level in Season of the Splicer, but we still have another ace up our sleeves in terms of power, and that's the artifact level cap. You see, Bungie wants to reward those who play often, and so instead of gear leveling being the only thing to chase, we also have a seasonal artifact. Every season, this artifact is going to be reset, and then we can grind artifact power through XP chases. This is a bonus power level that is stacked on top of your gear power level. This power level from your artifact can be grinded infinitely, but it's important to note that as you raise your power level higher, reaching a new level will take more XP. So if you are confused about how that works, let's say I'm 1265 power via my weapons and armor. On top of that, my artifact power level is at a 10. At that point, I'd then be a 1275 power level character. Some of you may have already seen folks who are in the 1340s power level, and that's because they've grinded their artifact quickly, plus raised their gear level as well. Once you understand all the tips in this video, it's very easy to understand how to reach these power levels very quickly. So if you need more XP, how do you get it? The key is four things: bounties, seasonal challenges, using your ghost, and boosts from the season pass. First, bounties are pretty easy to understand. You pick them up from all the vendors that exist in the game, like Shax, Zavala, Hawthorne, Saint 14, Drifter, the Splicer Servitor, and more. All of those items will give you XP bumps when you complete them. I see so many people who don't run with bounties while they're completing activities, and it's a huge waste. That's because most people don't like running back and forth to the tower or to the helm or anything else like that. I agree on that point. I don't like doing it either, but since last season, Bungie has made it possible to pick up all of these bounties via the Bungie app on your phone or your tablet. I am constantly checking the app to see if there's any random bounties I can pick up before I start playing an activity, and that way I always make sure I'm getting max XP for the time that I'm playing. Next up is the seasonal challenges. These can be found in the quest screen, and they unlock week by week by week through the season. A lot of these activities can be completed while you're hunting for your gear power levels or completing activities. The best part about these, you don't have to go pick these items up from a vendor. They're just always on. Make sure to focus on completing some of those seasonal challenges as well. You'll get weapons, bright dust, ether, and more, which can be used later on in the game. We can also learn to use our ghosts wisely. Since Beyond Light, we've been able to modify our ghosts to focus on material pickup, glimmer production, and yes, you guessed it, XP. Make sure you're always running the experience ghost mods on your character. I'm always running the blinding light mod on my ghost until I reach the pinnacle cap. Make sure you always have this on. The next step will require some friends, but it's pretty easy to do. It's the fire team XP bonus that you get if you own the season pass. Once you get to level 5, 26, and 56 of the season pass, the XP that you earn while you are in a fire team is boosted. So what a lot of us do in our community is collect a bunch of bounties and objectives and then get together as a fire team and pop them all while in a mission or a public area. You want to make sure that you don't pop those when you're in orbit because you will not get credit for them. By doing this, you will see your artifact power level start to raise up significantly and you'll be higher power level in no time. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is everything you need to know about leveling in Season of the Splicer. For those of you who have been playing, Bungie has only raised the caps on all the levels by 10, so power grinding this season is more about your artifact and chasing pinnacle gear. For those newer or lapsed folks, you can use all the tips and the tricks I've laid out to help you reach those power levels quickly. And if this video helped you, and only if it helped you, consider subscribing to the channel as I have a ton of new content coming with Destiny 2 as we move through the Season of the Splicer and the next expansions. In addition, a positive rating or leaving a comment is greatly appreciated as it helps the YouTube algorithm share this with other members of the Destiny 2 community. It helps so much and it means a ton to me and my channel. Speaking of which, if you are looking for a great place to learn more about Destiny or to find a Sherpa to help you through a vault of glass, come over to my Twitch channel at twitch.tv/manodestra. I've helped thousands of Guardians earn exotics, complete raids, get Grandmaster rewards, and have fun in PvP. It's also a great place to connect with all of you live. In addition, we have an amazing Discord that is full of places to find others to play Destiny, check gear roles, find out information about the community, and more. That link is also in the description. As always, thank you all so much for watching. Good hunting, Guardians, and I will see you next time in the universe of Destiny.